Geert Wilders' short film Fitna became an international sensation on the internet last year. It shows acts of Islamic terrorism next to violent verses from the Quran. Wilders, a Dutch parliament member and leader of the Freedom Party, has been one of the most outspoken opponents of what some call the Islamization of the Netherlands. Wilders has called Islam retarded. He's compared it to Nazism and the Quran to Hitler's Mein Kampf. And now he could be sent to jail for it. Last week, a Dutch court ordered that Wilders stand trial for hate speech. A lot of Muslims in the world would like to kill Geert Wilders. He's lived for the past 4 years under state protection, with a death threat over his head, and with a number of Islamic nations around the world wanting to put him on trial for blasphemy. And because of the tight security around Wilders, we were only able to film him in an interview setting. What was the purpose of the film Fitna?
Our country in the Netherlands, as many other European countries, is based on Christianity, is based on Judaism, is even based on humanism, but not on Islam. And this is what I wanted to show people, not by using actors, but by using real images and real verses from the Quran, that the Quran is not just an old book from 1500 years ago. It's a book that is still very alive today, and people get a lot of wrong incentives from it today. So I wanted to warn the people, and I was quite successful, whatever you may think about Fitna in the Netherlands. More than 3 million people watched it after 24 hours, and worldwide more than 20 million people watched it after 2 weeks.
I'm sure that people who've watched you provoke Muslims over the years wonder if you have a death wish. Are you secretly daring Muslims to try to kill you?
No, and I'm not even provoking them, as you said. I try to warn the people in the Netherlands and maybe even abroad in Western societies about the actual danger that Islam brings to our society and to our freedom.
Do you believe that a moderate or democratic Islam can exist?
No, I don't believe in it. I think there is no European Islam, there is no moderate Islam. Islam is, as I see it, a fascist ideology full of hatred, submission, and anything else that we should fight against. However, I make a distinction between the ideology, I believe Islam is more an ideology than a religion, and the people. There are, of course, people, Muslims. I have nothing against Muslims who are not terrorists, who are the majority of the Muslims in my country are law-abiding people, are not terrorists at all.
I've heard you call Islamic culture retarded.
It is a culture of backwardness, of retardedness, of barbarism.
You've been called a racist. Do you believe in the superiority of whites?
No, of course not. I'm not a racist. I'm not even in contact with countries like, parties like the British National Party who believe in black and white. I'm a Democrat, full stop.
In your speech to the parliament a few days ago, you referred to Muslim colonists. What did you mean?
Well, people that are coming to the Netherlands to stir up problems, or who are in the Netherlands, sometimes they are even born in the Netherlands, the younger generation and their parents or their grandparents were born here, they are not here to integrate, but to dominate. And they don't give them, excuse my words, for all the criticism and all the culture that we have in the Netherlands today. That's why I call them colonists. There are people living here from Morocco for 30 years who don't speak one word of Dutch.
So you see Islam growing, you see a government that you believe doesn't care enough. Where is the Netherlands headed on this issue?
The biggest problem we face today is that the dominant political culture is one of cultural relativism. Most of the political elite and political parties really do believe in cultural relativism, really do believe that all cultures are equal. Whereas I believe they are not equal. I believe the Christian and the Judaist culture is far better, and I'm not ashamed to say it. I'm not a racist to say that the Christian culture is a better one than the Islamic culture. There's an enormous gap between the political elite and the vox populi. And they see that our country is changing. They see in their streets, in their neighborhoods, in their cities, in their villages, they see that it's often not the Netherlands anymore. They feel that they live in little Morocco or little Turkey. We have an Islamic intifada today. I'm not exaggerating. In many, many cities and villages of the Netherlands, this is the problem. And the government looks in the other direction and ignores it, puts it under the carpet, all the problems.
Are you tired of living with a death threat over your head?
Well, not tired, but sometimes, not sometimes. Oh, I wish I didn't have it. And I'm not exaggerating if I say that I lost my freedom. I mean, I lived in prison cells for half a year in army barracks. I moved to places. My life changed a lot, and I can manage because people don't have to have sympathy with me because I feel I have a mission. My mission is very strong, and I really believe in it. And I know that if we really don't get a sense of urgency and act and defend our culture, defend our freedom, that it's too late.